Aye, this is just a wee disclaimer before listening to the podcast. As you've seen on socials, there's been altercations between Patrick, myself, and Redgate. And Patrick obviously isn't here right now, so this podcast was recorded beforehand. And on that note, Redgate, if you haven't already heard me from my social posts, June 21st, I will see any one of yous at the Tulloch Institute, and I challenge yous to a strap match, and I will see yous there.
Stay on, hopefully, now, because we're actually talking to it and it's picking up your voice.
Yep.
Yeah, so let's just get this out the way early, Kieran, okay? Because
I think we know what you're
we're
going
talking
about.
About it in the car, mm-hmm. And I know that Hunter's going to be annoyed that I brought it up, because he might have had one or two libations in Wembley Stadium that day.
Mm-hmm.
But Hunter, why, when I told you that when walking down the stairs out of All In, I saw Matthew Gregg from Botchamania and Cultaholic, I had a very nice chat with him. Like, oh, nice to meet you, Matthew. We'd already met Jack the Jobber that day as well. Mm-hmm. Nice. You were fine with him. You were fine with Jack. But why was it that when you met Matthew, you thought, I'm going to kidnap him and claim him as my own and give him the biggest bear hug I've ever seen in my life? I actually managed to get this mentioned on the Cultaholic Wrestling podcast.
Thanks for so much for entertaining us all every week. From Patrick Petersky of Fair City Wrestling. P.S. Matthew, I'd like to apologise again on behalf of my friend Hunter Redwood, also of Fair Seat Wrestling. We bumped into you on the way out of Wembley at All In last year. I was fanboying pretty hard, but managed to contain myself to just giving you a handshake. But Hunter ran towards you, picked you up, and spun you around like Swatowski did to Chris Rock in The Longest Yard. What a reference.
Mm-hmm. Which you probably saw, because I would have sent you the clip. Mm-hmm. I compared it to that scene in The Longest Yard. You know when Swatowski picks up Chris Rock and he's like spinning him around?
Yeah.
He's like, down, Shrek, down! That was like that bit in real life.
Yeah.
So why did you think Matthew was now your pet?
First off, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Nah.
Because you don't
have deny plausibility.
Starstruck, I guess.
Yeah.
I've been watching a lot of Botchamania.
Oh, mate.
It's brilliant.
Yeah.
It's so good. So maybe I thought I'd have a hero.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Okay.
Just wanted to show your appreciation.
Yeah.
I was looking to make sure there was no police around.
I know, yeah.
So it's all right. He's not actually kidnapping him.
He doesn't actually want to keep him.
It was like a misery situation where it's like, come and make videos for me.
Oh, do you really want to end up on Botchamania?
I know. Yeah.
It means you've done something wrong.
Yeah, I never thought that through.
But anyway, welcome back to the SCW podcast.
Welcome back.
I am, your co-host of this podcast.
Yes.
Firmly established now, Kieran.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we'll move on to that a bit later on, because we're putting our own stamp on it now.
Yes.
Duke be damned, all that. The last memory of that prick is gone.
Yes.
So NSFM are your hosts with the most, and we are going forward, Patrick Petersky, Kieran Douglas, on the SCW podcast.
Here we are.
And our guest this month, a man that I've been wanting to get on for a while.
Yep.
It is our good pal, Mr. Hunter Redwood.
Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. How you doing?
I'm not bad. How are you?
I'm excited. I'm excited to have you on.
I'm excited.
There's a lot of buzz about you, by the way.
No.
I've been hearing whispers in the trees.
Been a lot of good matches over the last year.
You're being touted as one for the future, mate. But I would say the future is now.
The future's now, old man.
But for those of you that have listened before, normally we would have gone into, originally it was Duke's five questions of doom that he came up with when he first started this podcast with Nathan North originally back in the day, until I, and then you came in, and I've definitely made it,
more entertaining.
There's a nicer vibe now. A much nicer vibe with Pretty Boy Sam.
Yes, I enjoyed that.
Because the last one before that was a bit tense when Duke came back on, because he was just chatting his absolute bollocks as usual. But anyway, so we kind of came to a sort of realisation that day, mm-hmm. that Duke sort of still thought that this was his, despite him not being on it for months on end. So we thought, right, let's get rid of the last trace of him. Mm-hmm. Let's get rid of his five questions of doom. And we're just going to cut a bit more loose with it.
We'll just
kind of not stick to this rigid formula, because we don't want everyone to be the same, do we?
Yeah.
Because then it might get a bit boring and then people stop listening.
Bit wild,
bit tasty.
Yeah.
Tasty, kid. Yeah, there you go. Welcome. But aye, so we're just going to have a wee blether, basically, Hunter, with yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Find out a bit more about you. So, Cairn, you were itching to ask something, so I'm going to let you go.
Was I?
Yeah, you
what? What was that?
Oh, you've forgotten?
I've completely forgotten. Oh, fair enough. We've been talking to him. It's gone. Yes.
Maybe a bit dizzy still from last weekend.
Mm.
But anyway, we'll get into that as well. Yeah. Hunter Redwood, we just want to know a little bit more about your childhood wrestling fandom. Now, Cairn's forgotten, but I remembered his question.
Was that right? Right, but
that's what grandpa was
doing. Yeah. I thought we were going to go and ask him about some of his matches and let him.
We should get into that.
You want to get into that? Plain it was. Okay. I remember. Yeah, I've got it. So, who was your favourite wrestler as a child? And who is your favourite wrestler now?
Because we want to see if it's changed.
It might be the same. It might be the same, but it might have changed.
Okay, well, when I was younger, 100% it was Kane.
Yeah!
Oh!
Attitude Era Kane, 98, 99, like, just the theatrics, like, everything about him, his size.
Yeah.
The mask.
Big red machine.
Speaking of his mask, Kane of all people is anti-mask.
That's funny, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a shocker. But anyway, sorry, you were saying.
Was it ironic?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
He's not wrestling anymore. I would say Triple H.
Yeah. We knew that was coming.
I knew. I thought Triple H would have been.
Yeah.
Would have been.
First off, it was Kane. Then it became Triple H in like 2000.
What was your favourite version of Kane?
I thought we were going to say favourite version of Triple H.
Yeah, we'll get on to that.
We can get on to that.
I didn't watch it when Kane debuted, so I missed all that. But then it was later on in like 98, so... you know what? It was when he was with X-Pac.
Mm.
Kane and X-Pac as a tag team.
Yeah.
Kane
and Daniel Bryan were a good tag team as well. I think that... what'd you call it? Opposites attract type thing. Yeah, the odd couple.
I mean, I still maintain... And that was an odd couple tag team as well, Kane and X-Pac. I still maintain that we should have got Green Kane.
Yes.
And we should have got Green and Black Kane. And Green Kane should have been in DX.
Yes.
Officially.
Yes. I can tell you my least favourite.
The fact
Kane.
That Tori was officially in DX, but Kane wasn't.
Yeah, I remember that. She had the green one. Nah, I don't know. I just always like Kane was red.
Yeah, it just suited him.
I just think Kane...
I tell you my least
favourite... I'm going to apologise quickly as well. I've got a bit of a cough, so if you hear that, me dying in the background, I'm sorry about that.
I'll tell you my least favourite Kane, though. Was bald, unmasked Kane.
Well, like corporate Kane? Because I liked Kane.
I just see that when that mask came off.
But at least he was still like.
Corporate Kane was different though. That worked more, but when he was Kane, and he didn't have the mask on.
I would agree with you up to a point, because originally when he had the mask off, he was still like mental. He was coming out to the ring in like handcuffs and all that at one point, and he was like, I mean. He electrocuted Shane McMahon's balls, and you of all people must have loved that. Because
that time he blew his corner. Just like his father.
Cairn Douglas loves him some Shane McMahon pain.
You're
a big Steve Blackman fan when he kind of sticked him off the Titans.
Yes, yes.
What about Triple H, though? What favourite Triple H?
Oh, 2000, 2001.
Mm. Did you meet... You know what, a photo?
Cairn's been doing that. Cairn told me as well. Do you remember this part of the conversation?
I do.
Yeah, you've read good stuff. You're not going completely mad, yet.
No.
Right, you've been doing his research, right? He's done some digging. And apparently you've met your namesake, Hunter Hell Stampley.
I have, yes. That was at a live show. After the match, I was like sitting next to the walkway.
Yeah.
And he went past me, went back again, and then came back and went right beside me. And he was doing his taunt.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, class. So I like put my arms around him.
And then he grabbed him and he went, you're the one to carry on my legacy. You're the one to carry on my name. You will one day grow an awesome beard and have long hair like me. Yes, I will, Hunter, I will.
And thus Hunter Redwood was born.
But you will not do the pedigree. You will do the sky high. Like D'Lo Brown. Yes, but better. Better than D'Lo Brown.
Yeah, exactly what happened. It's like you were there.
Yeah, I know, right? Do you remember who he was wrestling?
Not in that one. Nah.
Why am I just picturing you in the rafters, just watching this? This young
taking
Hunter.
Notes. Yeah. If one day I have a podcast, I will harken back to this.
My journal will be useful. Was that a live show or was that a...
Just a live show. I've never been to a televised show before.
I don't think any of us will be with the prices for Clash.
Oh, that's crazy.
Although, I've heard of one person that's managed to get himself a ticket. Body Guy Brandon, of all people, has scored himself a ticket for Clash at the
Probably
Castle.
Probably took a loan off of rich money.
Well, no, he's taking the family, I think. So the Body Guy family are going to have a great day.
Yeah.
Would have been good.
I can just watch on the telly and get a better view.
Well, and I can drink. Well, I think he's going to be quite close from what I've heard. But we'll hear from Body Guy in the future, I'm sure, about that. Because he'll no doubt be bragging about it.
Yeah.
He might try and get himself on the pre-show or something. Do we battle royal?
Yeah. Don't get me wrong, if I could afford a ticket, if I could afford it and money was no option, of course I would go. But, you know.
Hopefully they come back and it's Murrayfield and it's massive. And it's like...
Yes.
More like all-in prices.
Is it a Hydro,
yeah,
isn't it?
It's a Hydro in Glasgow, yeah. Hydro's only about like 12, 13,000. In fact, we'll check. Because we have the internet to look up these things.
Yeah, you can do it here.
You might do it. This is the race now. Is laptop or phone quicker?
14,300.
Damn it. I see, Hunter, that's when you've got to fill in. You've got a responsibility on this podcast.
Yeah, seated and standing and performing.
That's without a stage, though, is it? So it'll be even less.
Yeah, 14,500 with standing. Well, actually, no, it will be all seated, won't it? Because it's WWE show.
Yeah, but that standing area will become seated.
Yeah, so yeah, it'll be like 12,000. Did you know the construction cost was 125 million? Go through the Hydro's Wikipedia page now.
When did this become a construction podcast?
Yeah. Oh, now we're talking. That's where the real views are, man. Right, Billy, we're changing the format. But so, like, you said it yourself, so Kane from back in the day.
Yeah.
I'm going to push you for one more, because Triple H is retired. Active wrestler, who we're going with?
A lot of respect for Roman and what he's been doing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Said active wrestler. I'm joking. No, but
good. Nobody can see it, but we're acknowledging the tribal chief.
Well, that's it. See, you just put my point there. You put your hand in the air, and then Patrick did it as well. That's what people do. That's the bloodline. Without Roman, there would be none of that, and Cody's story wouldn't have been as good as what it became. Yeah. You know, Cody as well. A lot of respect for him and what he's been doing.
Yeah.
And also Drew McIntyre, because I was actually listening to his audiobook the other day.
I've got his book, I've not read it yet, but I'm planning to read it next week.
Is it on the list?
I'm taking it away.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, it's really good. It's better because he does it, he actually speaks it.
He's recorded it. I think Becky Lynch did that for us as well.
So it's interesting just hearing the whole story and envisioning myself doing that as well. Do you know what I mean?
Like, Hunter at the Hydro writes itself. well, that leads it into one of the things we want to talk about as well, because... What does Hunter Redwood want to do with himself?
Yeah.
In FCW and Dap Dap or whatever it is. Because you've already fought for a title already. You were in the final of the tournament to crown the inaugural.
Well, you had the first match of the... Who did you have in the
You were a surprise entrant. You wrestled Tom Atlas and Yuji Maki.
Who we've taken on as a tag match before as well.
You two have,
Took them on. Devious wee... I'll not finish that.
A Neo Paradigm back in the month. Oh, yeah. For that sort of brief few months where... Tom was sort of sucking all the knowledge out of you and that you could get his hands on before he kicked him at the cub.
And Tom just can't choose where he wants to be. He's
indecisive, man.
Yeah.
He's gone from Titanium to Teletubby to sort of just arsehole. Well, I can't stand it for it, man. But that's been well documented. But we'll try and not dampen the mood too much.
We'll not bring them up. But anyway, so you had them two. And you won that, and then that went through, took that through to the final.
Sebastian in the final, Sebastian.
Yeah.
And you were looking very, very well until the other three.
Oh, we do need to talk about them.
It
was the other two that night, sorry. Spike hadn't quite turned-coated on the fans.
Spike ran out with us, he played us.
Actually, I just had a very, very vivid memory that he didn't really do much, did he?
No.
Who? Spike.
Yeah. Because we were out trying to help you.
Right.
It was ourselves and you was there as well, wasn't
it? Yeah, it was
ourselves and you, and I think Botchko was there as well.
And I think that's...
And then Spike, I'm trying to remember, it was all a blur.
Botchko wasn't there. It was just us two, Ewan and Spike, that ran out.
Yeah, no, you're right. You're right, it
and
was.
And then you had Tom, Duke, Sebastian, and I think Rich Money ran out as well.
Maybe. Like I said, it was a blur. It was a blur. I can't really remember. But that's the point I've just remembered.
I was still focused on the match.
Exactly.
I didn't know what was
exactly,
going on.
Yeah.
That's why we came out.
I remember Spike doing very little, if anything, that day. And obviously, we now know why. He was clearly...
That's why I think Rich Money took a wee bit of dough to get out there just to kind of keep Spike away from it all.
Well, Spike was clearly in on the fix at that point. But we know from this lot that's been in the works for a couple of years now, so we shouldn't really be surprised. But yeah, I mean, like you could have been sitting here now as Dab Dab champion if it wasn't for all those shenanigans.
Yeah,
that's true.
So is that something you're wanting to, you know, try and avenge in the future? Like what are your hopes and aspirations for the next few years in the FCW? What do you hope to achieve?
I mean, the end goal is to be the FCW world, FCW heavyweight champion.
Mm-hmm.
No, you take that belt around the world and make it a world title.
Yes,
there you go, yes. World heavyweight champion.
Being in that match for the DAPW.
He's one of them.
I am one of them.
Oh,
I am one of them.
We're going to have to start like a scoreboard.
Spelling it out.
Yeah. Well, Pretty Boy Sam was one as well.
He said that. He said that. Dump. He said that.
Yeah, he did.
Join us by the end. Yeah.
Join us.
It's much easier to say.
I'll see how many things I have to say.
Yeah, exactly. This is what we do. We just keep bringing it up. Force you.
Yeah.
Force you to join us.
Abbreviate the abbreviation.
Yeah.
So to be in that match, I mean, that was huge deal for me.
Mm-hmm.
Was never in my wildest dreams did I think I would be in that situation.
Mm-hmm.
And coming that close to it, but not winning, it does fail you up.
Yeah, well,
okay. Mm-hmm.
Get back there.
I want another chance. I want to show people what I can do.
Mm-hmm.
And then even after the match, Ewan got on the mic.
Mm-hmm.
And he had said a few nice words as well, saying that, I can't remember exactly, but it was like, he didn't see that as being my last chance for that title as well.
It can't be, because it wasn't, you know, it wasn't...
It was robbed from you, I would say, that chance. Yeah. Like, you didn't get to fully prove what you had, because it was taken away from
Sebastian
you.
Sebastian Asher didn't beat you that night because he was simply a better wrestler. There was lots of moving parts and shenanigans that was going on. Like it wasn't a fair one-on-one contest by then.
Yeah.
If it was, the outcome might have been different. Who knows? So,
you just got
to keep grafting, mate, and get yourself back there. And fingers crossed you do.
Yeah.
Rooting for you.
That's the plan, man. I appreciate that.
Well, you have, because was it two shows ago?
You had Ryan Riley.
You had Ryan Riley. You put up a good fight against Ryan Riley.
That was a good match. I like that. I just want to go back and say that... that match with Sebastian, it was not an easy match.
I've waxed lyrical many times. I think he's one of the best wrestlers in the country.
Yeah.
I just don't like the way he goes about his business. He doesn't need to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
Yeah. But, so it's just to say, like, if there wasn't interference, who knows which way it could have went.
It would be nice to have seen.
It doesn't necessarily mean, I think, I definitely would have beat him. No.
Very humble.
Yeah.
Very humble. I like it. I like it.
So, the match with Ryan Riley. As I say, I enjoyed that match. I didn't enjoy what happened after the match.
No,
that caught us a few of us off guard, didn't it?
Yeah, that hurt.
It looked like it. I had a very good view.
Chair shots to the back.
I wouldn't want to get hit by anything. That's not my game.
You'd rather be the one doing the hitting.
I'd rather be the one doing the hitting.
That's a
That's
a good tactic, right? Don't get hit with weapons.
Just hit them.
Other people.
I'll try and remember that next
time. Not hard.
Life advice with Cairn Douglas. Hit and don't get hit.
Cairn's back corner, right?
When there's a weapon around, don't get hit by it.
Yes.
Move out of the way. But, like, again, the fact that you were in there with Ryan Riley, who's up until very recently, shout out to Retro Filth, he was a tag team champion at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we took a bit of offence, not at you, but it was the fact that that match happened in the first place. Ryan and Zach were saying there was no... competition left in the tag team division, so he was going into the singles ranks. And the fact, again, I think he went in there a bit sort of probably overconfident, underestimating yourself. Oh, Hunter Redwood, this guy's got maybe a bit of potential, but he's just one of the, he's just one of the guys from the school at FCW. He's not going to be any challenge. Like, he's not going to be any challenges for the inspirational Ryan Riley tag team champion.
Yeah, well, that's it. He'd never seen me before. He doesn't know what I was capable of.
You put him through his paces. I'll tell you that. He definitely put him through.
And the gloves
paces.
Came off literally at one point. And I was like, I've seen this in training, and it's not going to end well for him.
No.
That was it. It was just heat of the moment. Something had to be done. I was not getting the win at that point, and I just
Snapped him.
Yeah.
Took it up a notch, man. I like it.
Sometimes it's needed. I've been there myself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So there you go. He's shooting a shot. Yeah. World Heavyweight Champion. I mean, before we know it, it's going to be Rumble season.
That's, I think that's where me and you made our main roster debuts, wasn't it? At the Rumble last year.
It was. Yeah.
So that'll be us a year on FCW. I mean, everyone in that match is going to be going for the Game Changer briefcase.
Yeah.
But, I mean, obviously, my priority is with Caleb in the tag division. But you as a singles competitor, that's got to be, like, probably number one on your list for, like, this is my potential shot to maybe get that shot at the FCW Championship.
Absolutely, yeah. And going back to last year's Rumble, I wasn't in there for very long. I think it was less than 5 minutes.
Mm. Well, you lasted longer than me. Because Dickie Divers came in after he should have already been in and chucked me out when my back was turned. But hey-ho.
Yeah.
I'm not better about it.
Yeah.
I'm not better about that time when he didn't show up in the podcast. I hardly ever mention it. It's fine. On you go.
Sorry.
I took a leave of that one.
Oh, the amount of times I've heard this comment.
I know.
He's not better.
I'm not better. I just remember things. That's all.
The bug him.
But yeah, sorry. Your Rumble performance last year.
Yes. Didn't last long and didn't get to do what I wanted to do. So coming up for this Rumble, I'd like to
do better. Fair.
I'd like to do better.
Different strategy, maybe.
Be the last man standing. So
see, you can apply your strategy to the Rumble as well. Don't get eliminated.
Just eliminate.
Eliminate other people.
This is simple, Terence Howard math, right?
If you keep eliminating people, eventually there'll be nobody left.
There'll be nobody left, and you'll be. It's as simple as 1 times 1 equals 2, right? That's
this is Cairn's words of wisdom.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. And you're getting this for free.
Yes.
Yeah. You could be doing like online seminars.
You usually need to pay a Patreon for this stuff.
Yeah. Cairntreon. I am the Cairntreon.
Oh. Right.
I shouldn't be doing this to myself when I'm coughing.
Yeah.
Oh my god. But have we got any more questions for Mr. Redwood?
So it's kind of a similar one, but like, what's that?
No.
We've still got loads. It's kind of similar to one of the questions, but it's a good one to ask. To be fair,
put a different flavour on it.
What pay per view? If you've been to a pay per view or one you've seen, what is one that stood out to you that you enjoyed?
Oof. Well, I grew up watching the Attitude Era, so anything from there is, you know, the best to me.
Mm-hmm.
Royal Rumble 2000.
We'll see that.
All right, Johnny.
Johnny Presley.
That is an obvious one. That was such a good rumble.
That's an obvious one, is it?
Yeah. I've heard. Rumors, like just like he does his research, I've been doing some research on Johnny Presley, and I just want to chuck this in so the people of SW know. Apparently, that is his. You know, have you ever seen the? And this might sound like a wild comparison at first, but have you ever seen the Jeffrey Dahmer documentary on Netflix?
Yes.
Right.
Well, so you know, be going to this.
Right. No, stay with me. Right. Stay on the bus to the next stop. Right. So you know the bit, I think it's in the first episode where he traps the guy in the room. And he like tries to make him watch the film. I can't remember what film it is.
Yeah.
But like, so imagine now that man is Johnny Presley, and Jeffrey Dahmer is Johnny Presley, and the other person in the room is Johnny's date. They've had a lovely evening.
Chatting up, dancing
lovely,
all night.
Lovely evening at the bar, dancing the night away to some sort of 60s banger, and then would you like a coffee? Yes, I love a coffee. Come back to Johnny's suite for a wee coffee. And then apparently he likes to get the TV out and he goes, would you like to watch Rumble 2000? I'm like, John, you can't be serious. He's like, no. Honestly, that's like my, it's his go-to first date. Because I don't know if I like that in a way, because he's like,
does it work?
Is she going to pop it? Well, so the thing is, right, if it does work, then they're accepting Johnny's love of professional wrestling. And I'm like, I rate that. I just like the fact that he probably goes, oh, you need to watch this bit. Like, Takamichinoku was flying.
He knows his set times when he's going to say
something. So I reckon then, that for everyone going forward, if you're on a first date, show them Royal Rumble 2000. And if they immediately say no, then just bail out then. They're not worth it. Because they need to accept that you're a wrestler and that you like wrestling.
But Karen and Patrick are not responsible for your
relationship. No, if it goes wrong, blame us. Or Johnny Presley.
You can blame Johnny.
Actually, blame Johnny Presley. Yeah. It's Johnny's fault.
Don't blame us.
Just don't do the other stuff that Jeffrey Dahmer
did. Yeah.
Disclaimer, do not be Jeffrey Dahmer. Is there any, like, so maybe if not a single pay-per-view stands out from it, any like particular matches that you're fond of from that period then?
It was SummerSlam 98, it was The Rock versus Triple H in the ladder match.
Mm. Was that for the Intercontinental title, that
one?
Yeah, that was a good match.
Yeah. What else was there? The first one, you know what? I was actually watching this last night.
Mm-hmm.
It was Judgment Day 98.
Mm-hmm.
And it was when it was Kane versus Undertaker in the main event for the WWF Championship.
Mm-hmm.
And Stone Cold was the special guest referee.
Mm-hmm.
And then right at the end, they're both knocked down. Like, Austin stuns Undertaker, he does a double count, and then he says, "And the winner of this match, Stone Cold Steve Austin." But the point was,
not sure you can do that.
A bit of a mark for himself.
the point was, if he didn't raise somebody's hand at the end of the match, then Vince was going to fire him.
Oh,
so Vince.
So this was Austin trying to get around it.
Yeah,
yeah.
So then Vince comes out and fires Austin. Now I remember I must have been 10 at the time, and thinking, oh my god, like, Stone Cold's just lost his job.
What are we going to do?
I feel so bad for
this guy. I'm going to start watching WCW. God, sorry, excuse me. Keep talking.
One of, like, the first memories was, I think I just switched on Raw, and it was like Jeff Jarrett versus X-Pac.
The best Jeff
Jarrett. I think it was a promo about a hair versus hair match.
Mm.
That was like one of the first memories. Also, one of the first memories was Kane doing the shooting fire out of his hands. And hitting X-Pac in the face.
Not X-Pac. Here's a question for you. Would you be willing, if you were ever like in a position where you maybe your back's up against the wall and you need to throw out something to get somebody in that match, maybe somebody's wronged you, maybe similarly to how, you know, Duke and Atlas and Sebastian have wronged us in the past, you thought, I really need to raise the stakes here.
Mm-hmm.
Would you put your lovely luscious locks on the line in a hair versus hair
match? God, no.
Oh, no.
I thought you were going to ask him, would you like summon the power to shoot fireballs at your hands at them?
I mean, I think you're born with that. You know?
That's what I thought you were going.
Do you think you could do it if we'd like? Oh, can we do that live on the podcast? See if Hunter Redwood can shoot fire.
Not hair match.
Live on the podcast. I'm trying to shoot fire from your hands.
I have tried that.
I like that you've tried that.
It's never worked.
No,
no, not even close.
Are you getting from the telly with that?
Trying really hard.
Shit! That's happening.
I thought you'd back yourself in the hair versus hair match, no?
Too much at risk, isn't there?
Maybe is it one of those questions you don't know unless you're in the situation?
Yeah, that's
depends. Yeah, what leads to that situation?
It takes a long time.
What would the best hair versus hair match be in FCW? Hunter's got some lovely hair, and I think your beard would have to be on the line as well.
Oh God, Philly
Ball. Who could you match up side by side? Zach Dynamite's got a lot of long hair.
Mm-hmm.
You think he's or maybe Pretty Boy Sam. Baldy Sam.
Oh yeah, you wouldn't like that.
You wouldn't like that. Tom Atlas.
Tom Atlas. Yeah.
He's been growing his hair out. I've noticed that. He's been growing a wee bit longer.
Let's put that in the line. Emo Atlas.
I think Duke would happily put that in the
Duke
line.
Duke would happily just sacrifice Tom's hair.
Yeah. Who else?
I'm trying to think. I mean, that would be a good fatal four, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
What's that? It'd be Tom, Hunter, Zach, and Pretty Boy.
Pretty Boy.
That's a lot of hair on the line.
A lot of hair.
To do like a three falls as well, so like nobody's like three of them aren't getting away with.
Only one person's getting away with it.
Book it, Commissioner. That is the book it, Commissioner of the month. Fail. I tell him I'll give you one a month because I used to do more.
That's the he asked me to get you to stop doing that.
Tell Patrick to stop it.
I can't help him. I can't control him.
Do you know what? I've just got so many good ideas. Fatal four-way elimination here versus here.
Phallic.
Oh, here the dreads.
Yeah, the braids and dreads. Get sorry, them.
Five-way. Fatal five-way. Oh, God, right. Lads, we might have a wee break while I have a wee bit.
Yeah.
But yeah, and we'll come back and we'll do
we'll discuss the card.
Now we can talk to the viewers again.
Because you're back.
Patrick has survived his...
Coughing fit,
yeah. I don't know where I picked up. I think I might just be allergic to Tommy Cross's bull.
Yeah.
After what was happening last
Friday. It's been since we showed up there on Friday. You've been kind of a bit...
Yeah, I know.
I've noticed that. You've been a bit pale sometimes.
We had to do something because, right, ever since... I've noticed this as well, and you'll be the same because I've told you about this before. Ever since Redgate sort of kicked out JD Wild... Not seen loads of them.
Mm.
And it makes me wonder what Tommy Cross is up to. Like, why are they? Why have they been so absent?
I don't know. He's probably been stewing in his wee angry cave.
Stewing in his wee. Where is the red gate? Do you know where the red gate is, Hunter?
I've got absolutely
no idea.
I've got an idea where a blue bridge is, but that's about it.
We're only going to stand there and watch them gang up 4-1 on Sunday. So, and we offered them out right there.
We offered them the match, and they on our time. It's Tommy Cross.
Angry Tommy.
Ooh, angry boy.
He's one of the
Hello, FCW podcast listeners. It's Patrick here, from the future, from this podcast, but obviously in the past as you listen to this on Monday. This has kind of been a bit all over the place, this podcast, because as you would have heard at the start, Cairn has challenged any member of Redgate to a match, a strap match. At Tullock on Friday for what they did to me. They kidnapped me for, I think it was about a week. I don't really want to go into too much detail about it right now. I'm still pretty shook up by the whole thing. I'm booked in for surgery in Germany. This is Monday, so what? It's either Wednesday or Thursday I go in. I can't actually remember. I'm a bit woozy with all the treatment and stuff. But which means I'm unfortunately as well. I need to recover after the surgery, which means I'm not going to be able to be there to support Cairn. But one thing's for sure, I will be back as soon as I can. And this is not over between not only Cairn and Redgate, but Patrick and Redgate and NSFM and Redgate. We've got a lot of revenge, a lot of pounds of flesh that we need to take back off those guys. But one thing I will say as well, sometimes just due to time constraints or whatever, or the time of the month that they were able to get our guests together and talk about the podcast. One thing that hadn't been announced yet was the fact that Retro Filth are going to be defending the tag titles in an open challenge. So we weren't able to put that into the podcast. But so that's another reason why I'm just jumping in to let you guys know that now. Whoever steps up to face Randy and Ryan, I'm fully backing Retro Filth the champs to retain their titles. Because, you know, I think they're just on such a run right now, undefeated as a tag team as well, which you can't, it's hard to look past, so we'll see how our wrestling dads get on. But right now I just need to focus on recovery, and I'm sending all my best to my tag partner Cairn, who, you know, I'll not, without wanting to sound over dramatic, he probably saved my life. So thank you, mate, and all the best to you on Friday. And as for you guys on the SCW podcast, we'll see you now. I'll see you next month, because I will be back. Don't you worry about that. But for now, let's just enjoy the rest of the breakdown of the card with myself, Cairn, and Hunter. Thank you.
Let's talk about what is happening
next month.
Cairn, you are the dates and the time, so go for it.
We have June 21st back in Perth at the Tullock Institute.
The Empire Zone
is back, and you can get tickets online at the door and online at ticketsource.co.uk /FCW.
As per, I believe it's usually cheaper if you pre-order.
I think so.
But let's double check that.
Don't make false promises now.
Don't
sound a bit like Duke.
Oh no, God. Right, where are we? Sorry, I'm scrolling. Come on, SCW management.
Hold on. I may have had it here.
Yes. Online prices, £10 for adults, £12 on the door, £7 for kids, £8 on the door.
Yes.
And the family offer for as well, £30 or £34 on the door. So,
yeah.
I mean, I will say this as well. It goes for any sort of, especially like a local wrestling show, a mm-hmm. local music gig, comedy show, whatever. Get your tickets in advance, because then promoters and venues know that you're coming.
Yeah.
Because the last thing the venues like want to, it's like, oh, is anyone actually going to come to the show? Mm-hmm. I mean, we don't need to worry about that, because we've got a massive loyal fan base.
Yeah, we have a good fan base.
I know, for example, I've seen a few things blowing around Tayside recently where it's been mostly gigs of music gigs have like ended up cancelling.
Yeah.
Because they've maybe like, oh, they've been spooked by, well, we've got like capacity for like 200 people, but we've only sold 40 tickets.
Mm.
But it's because a lot of guys are going, I'll just get my ticket on the door.
Yeah.
But if they think they're not coming, then they're like, well, I'm not going to put the money up. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that was just a general bit of advice there for things. Get your tickets in advance. Not only will you save money for FCW as well, then we know that we're going to have a big raucous, big raucous crowd as usual. Cheering everyone on.
And you never know what you're going to see as well.
So, mm-hmm. Cairn, there was one match you wanted to talk about to kick us off.
Yes,
it's an intriguing one.
Yes, we have a new FCW Women's Champion. That is Brody Good. Adler.
Up the Adler.
Mm-hmm.
I've said it before, big Brody Adler fan, big fan of the Dynamite for years, and I'm very, very happy that she's got her hands on the FCW title again. Mm. And I think we're in for a much longer reign than our last one.
Yes.
Which she took her eye off the ball.
Yes, I think over the last maybe few months, maybe a wee bit longer than that.
Yes.
She's been denied opportunities. Oh, yeah. So I think now
Serena Rose was delaying the inevitable, yeah. I would say.
So I think now Brody is wanting challengers. She wants these opportunities that she's been denied. So they've offered that opportunity, and it is, they're making their Scottish debut.
Yes.
And it is Lucy.
Lucy.
So
I'm going to be honest, I don't know anything about this wrestler.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that might be, I'm not assuming this, but maybe it's the same for Brody.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't know who somebody is, and they've never wrestled in Scotland before, then it might be hard to plan for them.
That's a challenge.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what
you're... So it's a curveball. Yeah, yeah. Like, you might have expected maybe somebody like Emily Hayden, for example, mm-hmm. maybe to have been challenged with the title, like former champion, beat Brody last time for the belt. Maybe she would have been expecting somebody like that. But no, total curveball here in the form of Lucy. So it'll be interesting to see if Brody can keep this momentum going against a complete unknown.
Yeah, so I think that's one I think we'll need to go see. I'm putting my money on
it's based on A, I don't know anything about Lucy, but B, Brody's been phenomenal for the last year.
Yes.
Ever since she lost that title in the first place, she's been on a tear to try and get it back.
And she's done it. Yeah.
I'm very happy for her, and long may it continue.
Mm-hmm. Maybe you, Hunter. Who are you backing
this match?
Definitely Adler.
Yeah.
She's really good.
She is really good.
Definitely.
Well, it'll be my turn now then.
Here you go.
Oh, I've got it here.
There
you go,
you got it.
Now here's one. I've been told that Serena Rose is wanting to hold a funeral for her title reign. And not only that, I've heard that there may even be a coffin getting made to represent, I don't know if it's going to represent, is she going to be in the coffin and come out of it? Is it going to be for like, to represent the title?
This former champ loves drama, doesn't she?
Is she alright? Like, I don't think she's taking this very well. Has she gone off the deep end of it here?
I think she's still trying to get the attention back on her.
Because she has never been pinned or submitted in FCW until Brody took that championship off her. FCW's been around now since, 2019? It's a long time. I know she had a bit of a break in the middle, but it's the first time she actually been defeated.
Mm-hmm.
Full stop.
Yeah.
Like, so that's not good. If you've been, on top for essentially 5 years, maybe it's not a surprise that she's taken it a bit poorly, to say the least.
Yeah, but see where she's coming from. It's a bit excessive, though.
Yeah, it's very excessive. But could you class, though, the last few months before she got beaten by Brody as undefeated because she wasn't showing up?
She was dodging, bro.
She was dodging the match. So she tried to drag this reign out just a wee bit longer.
Yeah.
I'm glad Brody got that pin.
Because it was getting farcical.
I am intrigued to see what this is going to be.
Yeah.
Which she's thinking.
But yeah, I mean, it's not really a match, but I just wanted, I thought we should probably point it out because it's very strange behaviour from the now former FCW Women's Champion. But in terms of matches, let's talk about one of our good pals. Mm-hmm. We all get on with this boy around the table. Bochico is back on FCW.
Oh, he's back. And finally.
He's taken on one half of the Prophets of Doom. Recently we're having it out with the Gala Buddies, and the other half of the Gala Buddies in Retro Andy Valentine.
Yes.
Bochico's part. He's taken on Holden.
Oof. That'd be a good challenge for Bochico.
Something very different to what he's been in the ring with recently.
Yeah.
Because there's not many people around, I don't think there's anyone around, apart from maybe Solomon Grubb, that measures up like Holden does.
Well.
Oh, no, I don't, did it on. Did he start this again? Have you heard about this?
No.
Right, okay, I'm going to let you try and explain it again. And Hunter, you can decide whether you agree with Cairn or you think like me and he's talking absolute guff. Okay. And he doesn't understand what's real and what's cinema.
I know what's real. Look, I get they're big boys, but they're not as big as everyone makes out to be. See, when they're in the ring, it's forced perspective, you know what I mean?
I don't know, man.
Like, it's quite far away, and the ring makes you look that bit bigger, and it's just, they're not as big. See,
I've been in the ring with Grum. He's the one that...
So was he?
So that? Well, I got him at the Rumble. Absolutely. Fine. Right, so...
You got him at the Rumble?
I did.
He got me at the Rumble.
Yeah. King of the last Rumble.
Yes.
Who won that?
Yes. Because who came and helped go Grum out?
That's true. I mean, it was a team effort, but you know, you did pull the rope down.
Yes.
Thank you for that. Because I was getting beat up until you came out.
Yeah.
But yeah, so Cairn has watched Lord of the Rings one too many times, and he thinks that false perspective is now possible in real time in real life.
I've heard about the false perspective in the movie Elf.
Yeah. Cairn thinks that's real.
No. I've
movies
seen...
aren't real.
See, especially when you're that close to the ring, you're just very close. Whereas, do you know
next
what I mean?
Next thing you'll be saying, the camera adds £10. Is that right?
The ring adds about two.
Oh, the ring adds like 2 feet.
Maybe 5-6 inches.
So you don't think there's actually that much of a size difference between Holden and Bochico? So Bochico's gonna be absolutely fine.
Yeah, he'd be fine. But he's got this. Bochico's got this in the bag.
But I mean, we've been saying it before, but this is not the Bochico that we may have been used to in years gone by. He's a much more
aggressive.
There's something a bit about him. He's a lot more accomplished in that ring now. I think he was a bit tired of being the slips and flips and slips.
Got a bit of a chip on his shoulder now.
He's got something to prove.
Yeah.
He has been proving it.
Yeah.
He's got a victory over a former heavyweight champion in Yuji Make. Said it before, he nearly won the Rumble last year until Serena Rose cost him that. And I think the only way he's up for Bochico now that he's back in SW, I mean, Holden, you know, he did lose his last match against Randy.
Yeah.
So he's got something massive to prove in this. He's got to, you know, prove why he's been thought of as like one of these up and comers in the country right now.
Yeah.
And now that he's in this tag team with Solomon Grum, Solomon Grum's not going to be, you know, very happy if Holden's not getting the job done. So a lot on the line for both of these guys. Holden's got to prove himself to his tag team partner. And Bochico's, you know, he's trying to get back into title contention there because Bochico's very, very underrated.
Yeah.
And he's more than capable, I think, of going on a wee run and getting himself into championship contention. Speaking of championship contention. I'm sorry, I'm jumping the gun here, but this kind of, it makes sense to talk about this match now. Before we talk about what I believe will be the main event.
Mm-hmm.
Yuji Make, as we said, he did lose to Bochico recently, but he is a former FCW heavyweight champion. He doesn't lose very often. Everyone knows how big a victory it is if you get one over Yuji Make, because you know they're very few and far between. So Yuen is himself looking to get back into title contention.
Yeah.
Maybe it's well if it's junior title, or maybe he'll go after the heavyweight title again. But to do that now, the next man standing in his way is Luke Matthews, who's been a bit down on his luck recently in SCW.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So what do you think of this?
Well, as you say, Luke Matthews, he's not been having the luck, really, the
he's
past.
He's not been having the best time.
No, he's not.
Lost to Sam a couple of months ago, and then he had an impromptu title match with Robin at the last show.
And Jay put him back in his place. And,
for the yep. NatDub title, yeah. Jay came out, put it on the line, and then walked away with his title.
Yep, yep.
So, I mean, I actually sort of said it maybe last month, maybe it was going to be like what does Luke Matthews do now if he loses after Jay Robin? But the answer is now...
Take on a former.
The mountain gets even higher.
Yeah, take on a former, the former champ.
I mean, you've been in the ring with you and Punter.
Yep.
Like, and you had a bit of the sort of advantage there because you knew that you were going to be the surprise going into that match. They didn't have that time to prepare for you. How did you prepare for being in there with you and knowing that you were going to be in there with him?
Knowing that he's a former champion, I knew it was going to be a difficult match. He's a bit sly, a bit sneaky, you know, always.
That veteran instinct, as they say.
Yeah.
He knows how to use his size well. I think the common mistake that people make about Ewan is sort of, he's not the biggest guy in the world, so it's going to be an easy win. But Ewan uses all of that size to his advantage. He uses every pound of flesh that he's got.
He also uses the ring to assist him.
He uses his brain.
The biggest thing about Ewan, I think, is his technique, because his technique can overcome a lot.
Yeah.
And, you know, you only have to look at his highlight videos that he's very, very artistic in putting them out. He chooses amazing music to show them that he's a man that's not just an FCW, he's all over the country.
Yeah. Well, you look at his match...
Putting on fantastic matches. Yeah.
You look at his match history, the list is endless of opponents that he's faced. You know,
who's who? Just say Ewan's pretty good, isn't he?
Yeah, so he's got it. I think Ewan's got it in the bag.
I do. I think it's only a matter of time.
But again,
Ewan's back in title contention. But I think this is going to be the start of that for Ewan.
Yeah.
Could
Luke Matthew loses, could this be the straw that breaks the camel's back and maybe puts him somewhere else? He's thinking. Who knows?
Right. Should we talk about the main event?
Let's talk about the main event. We have the champ,
Dickie Divers,
versus the great Liston Ross.
Making his return to
Yes.
I believe, was it Nate Mercer last year? Was the last time that he was in the company?
Mm-hmm.
Where, if I'm right in thinking, yeah, it was, yeah. He defeated Ian Ambrose by knockout.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And if that doesn't tell you everything you need to know about Liston Ross, then come to the Empire Zone and find out how dangerous this man is. I mean, he powerbombed Ian to hell.
Yeah.
And again, Ian is one of the hardest men I've ever met.
Yeah.
And the only time I've seen him down twice is when Dickie Divers destroyed him with a ladder.
Mm-hmm.
And that was last November.
Mm-hmm.
And it was actually recently announced that Ian's making his return in July in Tampa.
Yes.
So that's what. 9 months he'll have been out with that injury, and the only other time I've seen him even remotely close to being hurt like that was when he literally couldn't answer a 10 count.
Yeah.
When Liston Ross just powerbombed him to hell.
Yeah.
In the Adler Complex. And Liston thinks he's now coming back up the road, and he's like, "Look, I've defeated Ian Ambrose. You owe me a title shot."
Yeah.
Because if you beat Ian Ambrose, you are in that conversation.
Yeah.
For a heavyweight title shot.
Yeah,
because he's on that level. So,
and then you've also got last month where Diver pinned Caleb, who's a big boy.
Yeah, arguably the greatest champion in FCW history.
So Diver might
to have that name on your list.
So showing that you can maybe defeat giants.
A big man, yeah.
So I think the management has decided to give him another giant to see if he can continue this. Yeah. I think that's the plan, and see what happens.
Can Divers be the giant slayer again? What do you think? What do you think, Hunter?
Yeah. Divers is again, like, sneaky. I would imagine him to have something up his sleeve to get the win no matter what.
Yeah.
I reckon it's going to be Divers that's going to be walking away.
You back in the champ?
Afraid to say it, but yeah.
Fair enough.
What about yourself?
I don't know. Like, that image of Ian laid out, it's been living in my head for a long time, and I was wondering when he was going to come back up the road and sort of demand something from FCW after what he did. And let's not forget whose payroll he was essentially on that night. It was Dickie Divers, because that was a pick your poison match.
Yeah.
And because Tom Atlas had beaten Ian, sorry, no, he'd beaten Divers the night before, mm-hmm. and perfectly Mercy night one. And Divers thought, right, who do I need to get to, you know, get a bit of revenge and make sure that Ian suffers a defeat as well? Big Liston Ross. And he absolutely annihilated him.
Which it makes me wonder how that dynamic's going to play out when they meet in-ring then.
So maybe Liston's like, look, you owe me a favour. You're a champ now. I'm cashing it in. I think this could be it.
Could be.
I think this could be it. I know that's like, and again, I've said before, and we've brought it up already, how dangerous Divers is, but we can see what happens when Liston Ross is motivated, whether it's by, you know, being on the payroll for Divers that night.
Yeah.
But if you're FCW Heavyweight Championship as your motivation, and you're
not wrong,
you're coming up here with that one sole single purpose, and he's a time to prepare for it. And he knows Divers.
Yeah.
He knows him well.
Yeah.
We know that. So, like, I can't see past Liston Ross. I really can't.
I'm kind of the same.
And if he wins, then, oh boy. Like, that's dangerous for anyone that's after that championship.
Yeah.
Maybe even more so than going after Divers, trying to go after Liston Ross. Because how'd you go after Liston Ross?
No. I agree with pretty much all the points you said.
Yeah.
And also on a biased point that I want Divers to lose that tail.
I know,
he was dodging matches for a few months as well.
I'll give Dickie Divers absolutely nothing but credit for defeating Caleb Valhalla.
Yes.
In any capacity.
Yeah.
But he has been doing a bit of ducking and diving as well.
Yeah.
But like I said, I think this is Liston cashing in his favour from Neil Mercy last
year. Yeah.
I think he might be getting a good payout in the form of the FCW Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah.
But this is it, like, the only way to find out for sure is to come to the show, isn't it?
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's the full card there, isn't it?
That's just been through everyone.
Yes. Well, it was good having you on, Hunter.
Thank you.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah, it's been fun, yeah.
Good.
Where can the lovely people of FCW find you on socials?
On Facebook.
Yeah.
What's your Facebook? I'm not too sure. It's just...
You don't know?
Just,
I'm sure it's just Hunter Redwood.
Well, Facebook, it's just Hunter Redwood,
Let's find out. Rather than just guess. I'm pretty sure it's just Hunter Redwood. Oh, there you go. You got a beautiful picture of your flights.
www.
Yes, go out there. Get following Hunter Redwood on Facebook.
Yes.
And,
I think there we all are.
Yeah. And you need to start posting more, buddy.
Yes.
I know. I need to start having more pictures.
Yes.
Yeah.
But get on Hunter's page and send the messages and tell him to post
more. Who's in the gym?
We want, well, let's see. Let's get, we in here, we know SCW management likes their gym photos of the wrestlers.
Nice.
get them posted, yeah.
Okay, that's and, fit for thought. So
and we'll see you at training next time, no doubt.
Yeah.
Absolutely, yeah.
So, I think we'll just wrap it up there, Kevin. So, do you want to do the ticket plug again?
Yes, you can get your tickets for the next show at ticketsource.co.uk/FCW.
And it's you can get them on faircitywrestling.com.
Yes.
Or .co.uk, I can't remember what it is. But the Fair City Wrestling website, there's a link to all the tickets there.
Yes.
And we've got a few shows on sale. Adlermania, of course, is on sale in September. Adlermania Part 2 in the...
Looking forward to that.
Yes.
In Dundee.
That'll be good.
That's our biggest show of the year in Dundee. And then our biggest show in Perth will be the Fair City Rumble the month after that.
Yep.
And that'll be in October. That's like always the biggest 2 months of the year.
But tell you what,
we've got a lot to look forward to before then.
The
summer's looking great. We've got galas out all over the shop. Before, by the time this comes out, we'll have been in Brechin. We've also got...
Lock, isn't it? Is that right?
There's a few of us, and again, this will be done by the time that the podcast...
Yeah.
A few of us are going down to Lock Winnick, as guests of Valor Wrestling as well. A few of us will be down there that day. We've got Ferry Fest coming out in Broughty Ferry on the 7th of July, so we'll get yourself along to that. We'll be back in Errol as well, I'm sure.
I think so.
The Errol Gala. Okay, I'm getting the list up. We might as well mention all these while we're here. Again, apologies if a few of them have already happened at this point.
The Errol Gala is on the 22nd, so it's after the Tullock Show.
You'll hear about the podcast, obviously, in the Errol Gala before the Tullock Show.
Yeah.
So we've got Errol, we've got Broughty Ferry coming
up. That's the 7th of July.
And then, I believe Methven as well. We'll be back in Methven. I think it's towards the end of July.
It's the end of August, I think.
End of August.
Okay. Yep.
Well, yeah, but there's that many.
Yes.
We
have loads. We have others as well. We're at Frockenheim Community Centre as well. So there's a lot. There's a lot going on.
Keep your eyes peeled to FCW's socials, and you will find out exactly where we're going to be.
Yes.
And where we're going to be wrestling all over Dundee and Angus.
Yes.
Or dot dot.
Dot dot.
But yeah, that. Right, we could go on all night, but yes. So let's wrap up there.
Yes, we'll wrap up there.
Our guest today has been Hunter Redwood. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
My co-host, Tasty Kieran Douglas.
Hello, thank you.
And I have been the king of the class, Patrick Petersky.
Yes.
And not safe for mums, well, we'll see you soon.
Yes, we will. Yeah. We'll see you soon. Have a good one.
Right, so we've met Matthew and we've met Jack the Jobber. So that only really leaves Ross Tweddle. So
we also met Simon Miller, haven't we?
Oh, we did meet Simon Miller.
I met Simon Miller. You didn't. I went.